In my previous video, I showed you how to tighten the belts in your Ender 3 and get better prints, but I had some minor flaws on the side of my CHEP cube. Well, I'm going to show you how I fixed those and how I improved my profile for Cura 4.4. I'll share that profile with you and all the steps to get there on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. This is the Ender 3 that I used. I used in a previous video installed this dual gear drive and also these adjustments for both the X and the Y axis to tighten the belts. And here was the result. If you don't remember, I had these bumps on the side of the X and also elephant's foot at the bottom. I knew what this was. I had the initial layer set to 120%. Now you won't see this in the preview, but it will flatten out. So I just reset it back to the 100%. But it was these bumps that I wanted to get rid of. And I thought maybe it was related to the seam. So I thought maybe I had random turned on, but I didn't. I had sharpest corner, but smart hiding. So because it's got smart hiding, you can see at layer 67, it's starting here at the X. But when it got up to 85 where those bumps appeared, now it was actually starting in the corner. So this is essentially random with that smart hiding. But I decided to try something different. Many people had told me to use coasting and it'll get rid of this. So I figured I'd try it because I haven't had a whole lot of luck with coasting, but I decided to try it. And so I enabled coasting, which says it will basically stop extruding at a certain point based on these parameters. And I played around with them, but the stock seemed to work pretty well. And you can see the gap. It's doing it on every outer layer. There's a gap where it just stops printing plastic and it just kind of lets it ooze out. And it definitely got rid of the bumps, but there's still some variation there. So I decided to play with the outer wall. So I searched on outer wall and realized there's a wipe distance that I could set. I had it set to zero and retract before outer wall. I had that enabled, so that was good. So I decided to go back to that wipe distance. So I decided to try this wall wipe distance, and it even says in Cura it helps hide the Z seam. So I should have done this a while ago. I set it to 0.4, or the width of the nozzle. And then you can see in the preview, it shows the wipe. It actually finishes the layer and then wipes into the print. Here it is in slow motion. It goes over and into the print. So any excess that may end up being a blob goes into the print. And when I printed it, this whole thing just looked a little bit better. So I decided to try another trick I've been playing with, and that is to set the outer wall to 95%. Even though everything's flowing properly, make the outer wall a little bit thinner. And it doesn't really show it in preview, but this whole print, everywhere I look, the edges of the X, everything just looked a little bit smoother by doing this. And you can probably play with the percentage, but I really like the way this looked. With all these new settings, I decided to get rid of the randomness and shut off smart hiding and put everything at the sharpest corner. Maybe it'll turn out good. But when I did that, I still got a lot of material on the corner of the X here, so I wasn't real happy with that. And this got me thinking, maybe random would work better. So I went back to the Z seam alignment setting and chose random. Now in the past, this left little extra plastic all over the print. You can see where the coasting is now all over the print. But when I printed it, it looked really good at 0.28. So then I tried 0.20 and it looked fantastic. So then I tried 0.12. Unbelievable. This thing was just so smooth, so good looking. This is the best CHEP cube I have ever produced. Next, I printed a Benxi at 0.2 layer height. The sides are smooth. The smoke stack was perfect. This is probably the best Benxi I've ever printed on an Ender 3. I was gaining confidence in this profile. So next, I printed my CHEP pawn, and this thing is near perfect. There is no seam on this round print. Absolutely no seam that I can find. So I tried printing really small. This is 25% size of the Filament, the Matter Hacker's test print. The detail on this is incredible. It looks really, really good with a 0.4 nozzle. So I decided to stick with this profile for now. I love the way these prints came out. I even printed some bigger ones. These are truly the best prints I've gotten on my Ender 3. These are some of the best prints I've produced on any Creality machine. And to get them on a sub-$200 printer, it's pretty amazing. But there's always room for improvement, so I'll keep playing with them. But until then, there is a link in the description below where you can download these profiles and try them out for yourself. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up. If you want to help support the channel, Patreon is one way, or just buy through the affiliate links in the description below. It all helps a lot. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo, that's free, and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.